Olabisi Olabisi Olakolade. This is the Black to the Future fashion show. Olabisi Olakolade is known in the community as Mama Olabisi. She was born and raised in Chicago, but has spent most of her life living in Florida, and was the founder and principal school cooperative. That was me. Too close to the speaker. All right, homeschool cooperative called Shule Aditunde in Tallahassee, Florida, and Orlando, Florida. Mama Olabisi has traveled and studied in Europe, Asia, Central America, the Caribbean, and Africa. She is currently working with Habishi Incorporated to build a sustainable agriculture institute in Ghana, West Africa. She has been living in Dayton since 2019 and is active in the Dayton Africana Elders Council, the McClendon Institute for Learning, the Dayton African American Culture Festival Committee for the African Village, and the Association for the Study of African American Life and History, ASALA. As the designer for the Dayton African American Culture Festival Afro Future Fashion Show, Mama Olabisi is featuring a wide range of community people, men, women, elders, and children, in clothing that expresses our vision of the future. We see a future that is creative, transformative, sustainable, and blacknificent. We see a future of thriving success, cultural awareness, and love throughout our community family. We are expressing the theme, Black to the Future, because our black is beautiful. Mama Olabisi. Mama Nozifo, how old are you now? 78. And she's one of the presiding elders, along with Kwaku Larry Franklin Crowe of the Dayton Africana Elders Council. And she's such a treasure in the community. Last year I was doing a little speech for her birthday, and I found myself going on and on and on, but I didn't repeat anything. Next to her is Elder Brenda Marone. And she's one of the mamas of the fashion show that has supported the fashion show legacy. We also have a seat beside Mama Nozipo for Mama Gail McLemore. She did the fashion show last year, and she is one of the mamas of the fashion show that's leaving this legacy. It's a significant fashion show because it's not really about putting on clothes, looking cute, walking around in front of people. The fashion show is not about showing off. The fashion show is about showing respect. Showing respect for where we came from. Showing respect for our elders and ancestors. Showing respect for ourselves in the way that we dress. And expressing our African identity through our attire and clothing. So we're going to get started with the first poem that is dedicated to the elders, and the elders will be the first group walking in their attire today. Some of you may recognize this as my length in here. Even though it's not very long, it's still very powerful. I've known rivers. I've known rivers ancient as the world and older than the flow of human blood in human veins. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. I bathed in the Euphrates when dawns were young. I built my hut near the Congo, and it lulled me to sleep. I looked upon the Nile and raised the pyramids above it. I've known rivers, ancient, dusty rivers. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. assigned to the person, their personality, their belief system. Darkness. This is for the brothers who don't believe in the lies. This is for the brothers who speak softly and carry a giant revolution. This poem is for the brothers. This is for the brothers who honor their sisters. This is for the brothers who honor their elders. This is for the brothers who honor their ancestors. This poem is for the brothers. This is for the brothers who remember where they came from. This is for the brothers who remember their culture. This is for the brothers who practice each one, teach one. This is for the brothers who raise our children. This poem is for the brothers. This is for the brothers who admit when they're wrong and try to do right. This is for the brothers who correct their brothers without having to fight. This is for the brothers who rose above abuse. This is for the brothers who paid the bill without excuse. This poem is for the brothers. The symbol is Jename, which means only God. Of African symbolism in African attire. David Kumba Greer.
Designed and put together
Bye. In its stead, this sparkling chalice, many souls have fed. And broken-hearted people on their knees lift up their eyes, and suddenly they seize on living faith and are comforted. Believing in the people who are free, who walk uplifted in an honest way, you look at last upon another day that you have fought with God and men to see. Great Amazon of God, behold your bread. We walk with you and we are comfortable. Bishop Clarence Norton.
Oh, Bishop. Oh. I see you, sir.
Didn't take no stuff, wasn't scared of nothing either. didn't come in this world to be no slave, and wasn't gonna stay one either. Farewell, she said to her friends one night. She was mighty sad to leave them. But she ran away that dark hot night, ran looking for her freedom. She ran to the woods, she ran through the woods, with the slave catchers right behind her. But she kept on going till she got to the door where those mean men couldn't find her. 19 times she went back south to get her sisters and brothers. 19 times she went back south to save her black sisters and brothers. Harriet Tubman didn't take no stuff and wasn't scared of nothing neither. Didn't come in this world to be no slave and wasn't gonna stay one either. Thank you to Mama Gail for making that effort and being here today. She is here. She don't take no stuff. Thank you.
Brother, pull the collar. Oh my God,
are the final walk of the model.
Off the runway, we will have our replica of the African wedding.